Yes. I think we'll stop the problems. We have done sufficient number of problems. Yeah, we will have some more problems based on these formulas. While completing, after completing the remaining topic, one more topic is there in the semiconductor physics. After that, we'll go for the problems once again. Okay. Next one is Fermi Dirac probability function. Fermi Dirac probability function. It is denoted as f of e. It's a probability function and is called Fermi Dirac probability function. Is equals to 1 by 1 plus e power e minus ef by kt. What is this Fermi Dirac probability function gives to us? It is the probability of finding an electron. Once again, it is the probability of finding an electron. If you want to find the probability of hole, 1 minus f of e. If you know f of e, that is probability of electron. Probability of hole equals to 1 minus f of e. Total probability equals to 1. So probability of finding an electron at an energy level e. The probability of finding an electron with energy or at energy level E is given by Fermi Dirac probability function. Now see here, case 1, what is EF means? It's a Fermi energy level. Case 1, consider right now T is not equals to 0, temperature is not equals to 0, then E equals to EF. E equals to EF. That means energy is equals to Fermi energy. So what is the probability of finding an electron at Fermi energy level? Is equals to, then F of E equals to 1 by 1 plus E power E equals to EF, that is 0 by not 0 quantity, therefore it is 0. It is 1 by 1 plus 1, it is equals to 1 by 2. So the probability of finding an electron with an at energy level EF is equals to 1 by 2. Case 2. Consider T equals to 0 and E greater than EF, then F of E equals to 1 by 1 plus e power e greater than ef. E greater than ef means it's a positive quantity. Positive quantity by 0. One something by 0. Infinity plus infinity. Because the numerator is a positive quantity. So it is 1 by e power infinity is infinity. Infinity plus 1 is infinity. Infinity is equals to 0. That's what is the meaning of this thing. Probability of finding an electron with energy level greater than EF is equals to 0 at temperature equals to 0. Clear? Next, case 3. If T equals to 0, E less than EF, then what is F of E, Fermi energy, Fermi Dirac probability function? 1 by 1 plus E power E less than EF. This means this quantity becomes now, in this case, negative. By denominator is 0. Therefore, some minus quantity, 1 by 0, that something by 0, it's infinity. And it is minus infinity. 1 by minus infinity is 0. Therefore, it is 1. Now, what is the meaning of final conclusion? The probability of finding an electron with energy at energy level less than EF is equals to 1. Above EF, 0. That means if you take this is Fermi energy level, all these energy levels are filled with electrons, filled states with electrons. Here, these are empty states. What is the meaning? This is F. The probability of finding an electron with energy level greater than F equals to 0. That means there are no electrons, empty. The probability of finding an electron with energy level less than F equals 1. That means if you take here, the probability is 1. Compulsory there is existence of electron. So below F, electrons will exist. Above that one, no electron is exist. That's empty states. Now if you see this thing, this is F of E, this is E minus EF. Here it is 1. Probability of finding an electron is 1. Here it is 0.5. Here it is 1.5, here it is 0. Here this is E equals to EF, this point. So this point is E greater than EF. What is the probability of finding electron E greater than EF? It goes on decreasing or not? It becomes 0 or not? What is the probability of finding electron here? E less than EF. What is the probability of finding an electron here? It's larger value, equal to 1. So here equal to 1 and nearer to 1, here nearer to 0, at this point it is 1, this is the thing. Okay. This is known as Fermi Dirac probability function, which indicates what is the maximum energy that is possessed by electron at 0 degree Kelvin is nothing but Fermi energy level. Above Fermi energy level, no electrons are available at 0 degree Kelvin. All are below the Fermi energy level. That means conduction band contains 0 electrons, valence band contains full electrons. Therefore, at 0 degree Kelvin, semiconductor acts as a insulator because there is no availability of charge carriers above F. Above F, conduction band will be there. Clear? Next comes another. Fermi energy level EF. To calculate the Fermi energy level, we require electron concentration and hole concentration. There are two formulas are available, this electron concentration, hole concentration. N equals to nc into e power. Electron concentration N, Nc into e power Ec minus Ef by kT, P equals to Nv into e power Ef minus of Ec minus of Ef minus Ev by kT. Okay. Now, here what is Nc and Nv are constants. It is 2 into 2 pi mn k bar t by h square whole power 3 by 2. Nv is a constant and it is 2 pi mp k bar t by h square whole power 3 by 2. What is this k bar? We know t, we know. Okay, this is h. Please differentiate n and h. This is m suffix n, this is m suffix p. M suffix n is called effective mass of an electron. M suffix p, effective mass of hole. What is this effective mass and mass. We know mass of an electron 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. That is called rest mass. That means at this it is at rest. Then the mass of electron. If electron is moving, then its mass is going to change. That is called effective mass of an electron, effective mass of an hole. Okay? When the rest mass is different from effective mass. Rest mass means, that is, we are denoting it as M or somebody can represent it as M naught. That is called rest mass. At rest, if it is moving, then its mass is going to change. That is called effective mass. H is called Planck's constant. H is called Planck's constant, and its value is given as H equals to 6.63 into 10 power minus 34 joules second. 6.63 into 10 power minus 34 joules second is the Planck's constant. NC and NV are constants because all these are constants only. This is electron concentration is given by this formula, hole concentration is given by this formula. Next question. Now, Fermi level we are going to calculate for an intrinsic semiconductor. For an intrinsic semiconductor, where is the Fermi level lies? For an intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons is equals to number of holes. Number of electrons is equals to number of holes. This is number of electrons, this is number of holes. Therefore, this can be written as NC into e power minus of EC minus EF by KT, NV into e power minus of EF minus EV by KT. Because number of electrons equals to number of holes. From this one, NC by NV, NC by NV equals to e power minus EF minus EV by KT divided by e power minus of EC minus EF by KT. From this one, NC by NV equals to e power, if you go up, this is EC plus EV minus EF minus EF minus 2 EF by KT, by KT. So this can be written as EC plus EV minus 2 EF by KT equals to ln of NC by NV. So from this one, if you derive expression for EF, what is EF? This is Fermi energy level in intrinsic semiconductor. Fermi energy level in intrinsic semiconductor is equals to, you are going to get it as EC plus EV by 2 minus KT by 2 ln of NC by NV. EF, Fermi energy level in an intrinsic semiconductor is equals to EC plus EV by 2 minus KT by 2 ln of NC by NV. That means where is the Fermi level lies? This is conduction band, this is valence band, this is EV, this is EC. Now, NC and NV, what is the difference? Here MN, here MP. Let us assume MN equals to MP for simplification purpose. If this and this are same, NC and NV are same, this is same. Logarithm of 1, natural logarithm of 1 is 0. Therefore, this entire term becomes 0. Therefore, the Fermi level lies exactly middle. That indicates number of electrons is equals to number of holes. In an intrinsic semiconductor, Fermi level lies exactly middle of the forbidden energy gap. That indicates number of electrons is equals to number of holes. Clear? Only the assumption is we are assuming mass of an effective mass of an electron equals to effective mass of hole, then this one. Otherwise slightly will change. This parameter has to be considered. Whether NC is greater means EC plus EV means middle. This NC is greater than 1 means this is a positive quantity. It will be slightly below. Instead of here center comes down. If NV is greater than NC, assume in that case this becomes a negative quantity. Negative or negative becomes a positive quantity. Therefore it goes little bit up. Because that's only the difference. Next. So Fermi level in intrinsic semiconductor lies exactly middle of the forbidden energy gap. Now we'll calculate in n-type semiconductor where the Fermi level lies. In n-type semiconductor where the Fermi level lies. For an n-type semiconductor we know that N equals to ND approximately. This is electron concentration equals to donor impurity concentration. What is N? We know. This NC e power minus half EC minus EF by KT equals to ND. From this one, e power minus half EC minus EF by KT equals to ND by NC. Minus half EC minus EF by KT equals ln half ND by NC. That is, EC minus EF equals to KT NC by ND by NC, ND by NC, ND by NC, okay. It's minus EC, it goes like this, plus EC, yeah, it's correct. This can be written as minus minus, this becomes EF, minus EC goes that side, EC plus KT ln ND by NC. This can be written as EF equals to EC minus KT ln NC by ND. This is valence band, this is conduction band. The Fermi level in n-type semiconductor lies EC minus. So EC is this one, minus means here. Fermi level lies just below the conduction band, minus KT ln. Clear? The Fermi level lies just below the conduction band. Now, let us suppose ND is very increased. ND is increased. This is constant. ND is increased means the denominator is increasing. So what is going to happen? This becomes a negative quantity. Negative of negative becomes a positive quantity. In that case, the Fermi level lies inside the conduction band. Clear? With normal doping, this ND value is smaller than NC. Therefore, this is a positive quantity. Positive quantity minus. Therefore, Fermi level lies just below the conduction band. Now, doping level is, that's first point. In normal doped N-type semiconductor, Fermi level lies just below the conduction band. How much just below means? That is KT ln NC by ND. Let us assume that you take a heavily doped diode, example tunnel diode. Heavily doped diode, ND is very high. Denominator is very high means this quantity becomes, this logarithmic of this quantity is some point, 0. Something you are getting mean. Logarithmic of this one becomes a negative quantity. Negative of negative becomes a positive quantity. Then Fermi level lies inside the conduction band. One of the gate question. For heavily doped p-n junction, the depletion, the Fermi level lies inside the conduction band if it is an n-type semiconductor. Okay. Next point, first point we have seen Fermi level lies just below. Second point inside if doping is very high. Third point, if temperature is increased, what is going to happen to this quantity? Increases. This quantity is increasing means what happens to Fermi level? Shifts down. As temperature increases in n-type semiconductor, Fermi level comes down, moves to downward direction. It's clear? Next, p-type semiconductor. P-type semiconductor. In P-type semiconductor, we know that Na equals to P. That is, Na equals to P. Nv into e power minus of this. Then, e power minus of Ef minus Ev by KT equals to ln of Na by Nv. Now, e power if you are, okay, we'll take that at the end. Minus of Ef minus Ev equals to KT ln Na by Nv. Therefore, Ef equals to Ev minus KT ln Na by Nv. Therefore, Ef equals to Ev plus KT ln Nv by Na. This is conduction band. This is valence band. For a p-type semiconductor, Fermi level lies just here Ev plus. This is Ev. This is Ec. It lies just above the valence band. Therefore, here it will be. Fermi level lies just above the valence band. Is clear? Now, if Na is increased, that means doping level is increased, this quantity becomes negative. So here negative. Therefore, Fermi level lies inside the valence band if it is heavily doped. For normal doped, Fermi level lies just above the valence band. For heavily doped, such as a tunnel diode, Fermi level for a p-type semiconductor, Fermi level lies just inside the valence band. Clear? Next. Next. If temperature is increased, this quantity goes on increasing. That means it's EV plus increasing quantity. Therefore, Fermi level lies like this, upward direction. In N-type semiconductor, as temperature increases, Fermi level comes down. In P-type semiconductor, as temperature increases, Fermi level goes up. So overall, in extrinsic semiconductor, as temperature increases, Fermi level moves towards the center. From up comes to center, from down goes to center. So either N-type semiconductor or P-type semiconductor, as temperature increases, Fermi level moves towards the center. That's exactly speaking, N-type semiconductor moves down, P-type semiconductor it moves up. Clear? Next. Intrinsic concentration. Intrinsic concentration. We know that N into P equals to Ni square. For an intrinsic semiconductor, it is denoted Ni Pi. So we know N and P, so substitute here, NC, NV, e power minus half, EC minus EF by KT, e power minus half, EF minus EV by KT is equals to Ni square. Ni square is called intrinsic concentration. So Ni square is equals to NC NV e power minus EC minus EF plus EF minus EF cancels by KT. If we take minus EC plus EV plus EV, this can be written as NC NV e power minus half EC minus EV by KT. This can be written as this NC NV e power minus EG by KT, Ni square. Now what is EC minus EV? Nothing but forbidden energy gap, yesterday's figure. EC minus EF is equals to EG. Therefore, here we are going to get it as EG. Is it clear? Next. So, we know NC, we know N. Substitute here. All these are constants. Okay? So, that also becomes a constant. Except temperature. Temperature will change. Therefore, this can be written as, if you take all these constants as A naught, some constant, except temperature. Temperature here T power 3 by 2, here T power 3 by 2. T power 3 by 2 into 3 by, okay, plus 3 by 2. So here we will get T cube, okay, into E power. Forbidden energy gap also changes with respect to temperature. What happens with respect to temperature? As temperature increases, forbidden energy gap decreases. Therefore, minus EG minus, this is beta into T by KT. We'll, instead of A naught, we'll take A first. Then this is A T cube e power minus EG by KT into e power minus minus become big plus TT will cancel beta by K. Once again, this beta and k is also constant. Take now this a and beta naught as a naught t cube minus e power, this is easy naught ni. Is not by kt. Intrinsic concentration equals to a naught into t cube e power minus is naught by kt. What is is naught? Forbidden energy gap at 0 degree Kelvin, absolute 0. Forbidden energy gap at 0 degree Kelvin is denoted as minus is naught. Okay. Now, what happens as temperature increases? Intrinsic concentration increases. Clear? This one more formula important. Next. What is the difference between Fermi energy level in intrinsic semiconductor and in n-type semiconductor? How much difference? That is, the difference between Fermi energy level in intrinsic semiconductor and Fermi energy level in n-type semiconductor. We'll see. Now, for an n-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are electrons. Therefore, this is n equals to nc into e power minus ec minus ef. By this formula holds good general. For an n-type semiconductor, n equals to, we know nn is nothing but nd. Nd equals to nc into e power minus of ec minus ef n by kt. What is this EFN? Fermi level for an n-type semiconductor. Equation number one. Clear? Now, for an intrinsic semiconductor, N is denoted as NIE. It's NC e power minus of EC minus EFI by KT. Equation number 2. Okay. Equation number 1 divided by equation number 2. ND by NI equals to NC will cancel. So this is E power minus EC plus EFN plus EC plus becomes minus EFI by KT. EC, EC also will cancel. Therefore, EFN minus EFI equals to KT ln ND by NI. The gap between, the separation between Fermi energy level in n-type semiconductor to an intrinsic semiconductor is equals to KT ln of ND by NI. Clear? In one of the, some of the problems, he will give these things, he asked to calculate this difference. Okay, we'll do some problems based on this one. In that case, we require these formulas. Is it clear? Next. What is the difference between Fermi energy level of p-type semiconductor to Fermi energy level of an intrinsic semiconductor? P-type semiconductor means here we have to take p. This is the general formula for a p-type semiconductor. Majority charge carriers are holes, neglecting the minority charge carriers, electrons. Now, for p-type semiconductor, pp is nothing but Na. Na equals to Nv into e power minus half Efp minus Ev by kt. Equation number 1. For an intrinsic semiconductor, this denoted as Pi. Pi or Ni both are same. Intrinsic semiconductor number of electrons equals number of holes. Either Pi or Ni both are same. Nv e power minus half Efi minus Ev by kt. Equation number 1 divided by equation number 2. So here we are going to get it as Na by Ni or Pi equals Nv and we cancel e power minus Efp minus Ev minus minus becomes plus Efi plus minus minus here it is plus minus Ev by kt. Therefore Efi minus Efp, Efi minus Efp equals to kt ln of Na by Ni. Clear? These are the theoretical things related to the Fermi energy level. Now we'll do some problems on these things, then we'll go for the next topic. Yes. A silicon is doped with boron impurities. A silicon is doped with a boron impurities of a concentration of boron impurities means acceptor impurities, that is Na, is given it as 4 into 10 power 17 atoms per centimeter cube. 4 into 10 power 17 atoms per centimeter cube. Assuming intrinsic carrier concentration of silicon Ni, it's coming it as efficiency, it's not efficiency, it is Ni equals to 1.5 into 10 power 10 atoms per centimeter cube. He given boron impurity concentration, nothing but acceptor impurity concentration, intrinsic concentration Ni. Then he is given kT by Q is 25 millivolts. Now, then, okay, he is given, that is the data given. Compared to undoped silicon, Fermi level of doped silicon is compared to undoped silicon, that is intrinsic semiconductor, Fermi level of doped semiconductor, it's a p-type. Okay, options are, goes down by 0.13 electron volts, goes down by 0.427 electron volts, goes up by 0.13 electron volts, goes up by 0.427 electron volts. Once again, I'm repeating. Option A goes down by 0.13 electron volts. Goes down by 0.427 electron volts. Goes up by 0.13 electron volts. Goes up by 0.427 electron volts. He is asked to calculate what is the relationship between EFI and EFP. Intrinsic semiconductor Fermi level and P-type semiconductor Fermi level. Just previously we have derived formula. What is that formula? EFI minus EFP is equals to KT ln Na by Pi. Already I said either Ni or Pi both are same. Intrinsic concentration, number of electrons is equals to number of holes. Therefore, this both are same. Therefore, substitute EFI minus EFP is equals to E given KT ln Na 4 into 10 power 17 Pi 1.5 into 10 power 10. It's given room temperature. He given KT by Q, but it is ours is this is nothing but KT or K bar T by Q, both are same. Actually whatever given in the problem is, it's nothing but K bar T is given. So directly you can take this is 25 millivolts substitute. I think you are going to get it as here 0.427 electron volt. EFI minus EFP. So EFI equals to EFP plus 0.427 electron volts. Just check it whether it's a minus or plus based on that. So compared to an intrinsic semiconductor, for a P-type semiconductor, you will obtain the intrinsic semiconductor Fermi level by adding this one to this one. So which is at higher position, EFI or EFP? EFI is at higher position, EFP at down. That means in intrinsic semiconductor Fermi level is here EFI. Take it as this is EV. So here it is EFP. So in by adding impurities, without impurities Fermi level is here. With adding impurities Fermi level comes down. How much it is coming down? That is nothing but 0.427 electron volts. So it comes down by 0.427 electron volt. Next. Next problem. Next point. A pure silicon is doped with 5 into 10 power 15 phosphorus atoms per centimeter cube. A pure silicon is doped with 5 into 10 power 15 phosphorus atoms per centimeter cube. If the effective mass of an electron is effective mass of an electron is 0.5 of m0, m0 is rest mass, then how far the Fermi level moves from the conduction band at room temperature? How far the Fermi level moves from the conduction band at room temperature? Okay. Now, he is not given a comparison between Fermi level of intrinsic semiconductor and p-type, n-type semiconductor. He is asking for an n-type semiconductor where the Fermi level lies. That is, Fermi level in n-type semiconductor is Eb minus Ef, sorry, Efn equals to Ec minus KT ln Nc by Nd. Nd is given, T is room temperature is given. Whether Ec is given, okay, no need, because he is asking Efn minus Ec, not this one. Ec minus Efn equals to KT ln Nc by Nd. So Nd is given. What is Nc? 2 into 2 pi mn k bar T by h square whole power 3 by 2. Mn is given it as 0.5 m0. That is 0.5 into 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. H, Planck's constant, given 6.65 into 10 power minus 34. Boltzmann constant K bar is given in the previous problems. T given. Here T is given. Here K is given. Substitute all these things. You will get it as Ec minus Efn equals to 0.54 electron volt. That means here it is Ec means here it is Efn. This gap is 0.54 electron volts. 0.54 electron volts. Next. Next problem. I think the problems are sufficient. Okay, now whatever the problems completed till now, I think it's sufficient for the semiconductor physics. After break, we'll start with the PN junction. Clear? Okay, now we'll have a break. Yeah, we'll take the questions. It's first question. It's Piyush Birani. Sir, are there any exceptions to law of neutrality? Sir, please explain the phenomenon of recombination current and also tell, do ions contribute flow of current? Yes. Are these ions, whether it will contribute the current or not? Now I am going to take that part. That's why I have not explained anything about the ions till this point of time. Because in p-n junction, once I am going to come to the p-n junction, the basics will start from the ions only. So that's why I have not taken that part. I will explain right now. Any exceptions to law of neutrality? No. Always, once again, the number of electrons, number of holes, positive charge, negative charge, anywhere it will be satisfied, that one. For metals also it will be satisfied. Then you can ask, sir, metals, only electrons are there, no holes concept in metals. Then entire thing, it has to be positive charge or negative charge or not. How a metal is once again electrically neutral? Their ions, they donated one electron. Donated one electron means becomes a positive ion. So one electron is donated, electron negative charge, and ion positive charge. So it will be compensated. That also I will explain. Clear? Next, explain the phenomenon of recombination current. Okay, this recombination current comes in the transistor while basic construction of operation of the transistor. At that time, I think it's better to understand the recombination current, how and why that comes into the picture. Clear? Till now, the ions whether contribute or not, that we'll see this point. Recombination current we'll see in the transistors. There is no exceptions to law of neutrality as of my knowledge. Clear? Always it has to be total positive charge is equal to total negative charge. Then only all the materials are electrically neutral. Clear, Piyush? Next. Rama, what are the books for this subject? For electronic devices, the standard textbooks are, you can go for electronic device and circuits by Millman and Alkias. Okay? That's first part of this electronic device, BJTs, semiconductor physics, BJT, diodes, transistors, all these things. Whereas for VLSI is G, SJDE, VLSI fabrication, the textbook is SJE. Then VLSI working, then you have to go for some VLSI textbook, Pucknell, okay. Otherwise, there are some other textbook. At that time, I will give what are the textbooks. Clear for that VLSS, theoretical thing. But for this one, Millman Alkias is more than sufficient. Next, it's somebody will follow Sedran Smith. That also, yes, Sedran Smith. But mine is mostly from Millman Alkias. Next, Abhishek Paul. Sir, which books to be referred for EDC? That's clarified right now, again. Next, Piyush Binani. Sir, if Fermi level lies inside the conduction band, is there a possibility of partially filled conduction band? As you said that probability of electron above Fermi level is zero. Yes, good question. Okay. Fermi level lies inside the conduction band. Is there possibility of partially filled conduction band? Yes. We are going to see that whatever you asked, it comes under tunnel diode. In tunnel diode, that part comes in detail, I will explain at that time. Clear? What is this valence, filled states, empty states? That entire tunnel diode concept explains with the Fermi level only. Clear? At that time, I will explain. Clear, Piyush? Next. Next, we are going for a diode.